Hello students, today in this video we are going to study about human eye and colorful world. So today is the introduction class. So let's see what is this chapter telling about. Basically you can connect this chapter with the real world and the natural phenomena that occurs all around us. So let's see what is the human eye and colorful world about. Here I have given the illustration that here we know that sun is the ultimate source of energy. We get all the energy, all the light that we get from the sun. It's the ultimate source of energy. And here the nuclear fusion always occurs inside the sun. Here the nuclear fusion. Fusion is basically when two small nuclei join, fuses. So here the hydrogen nuclei, basically hydrogen atoms, the nuclei of hydrogen atoms, they get fuse and produce helium. And this phenomena always regularly occur inside the sun. And the core of the sun, 500 million metric ton of hydrogen get fuses. And due to this regular process, we get a lots of energy. And we get this energy in the form of light, or we can say that in the form of radiation. So let's see what happens. These light, that we call it light, is we already know that light shows the property of both wave as well as particle. So these lights, the photon, in the form of photon or energy particles, they travels from atmosphere to earth surface. During the travel, some of the photons get absorbed in the atmosphere and some reaches to the earth surface. And these light get absorbed in the atmosphere. Due to that, we get a different color of the sky. There is a different color, you can find a different color in the atmosphere. We will discuss it later. Now, after reaching of this photons in the form of electromagnetic waves, they reaches at atom of the matter. We know that in the earth surface, everything is made up of atom. Matter is made up of atoms. So these light ray gets absorbed by the atoms. And when these atoms of the matter get absorbed the light, then some of the light or photon get absorbed, some get reflected, and when the reflected photon comes in our eyes, we are able to see the things. So we can say that if we are thinking about ourselves, if there is no light present, then our body, we are not able to see our body also. So whatever the photon comes from the sun, they get absorbed by the atoms of the matter, and some are reflected, and that reflected atoms, some get absorbed, some get reflected, and the reflected photon, means reflected light, enters our eyes, into the eyes, and we are able to see the vision. We are able to see the things. So in this way, how it give the sensation of visibility. So this is the way. Now we know that, we already know that the light shows the electromagnetic radiations, means it is in the form of electromagnetic waves. I'm showing this photon is coming towards the earth surface in the form of electromagnetic waves. So here electromagnetic waves, so here we are also know that only the some wavelength we are able to see the light, means only this vibgyor, vibgyor, they all are written in a color, same color. So here the visible light, this spectrum of light, only this white light is the mixture of these all wavelengths, but the visibility, that only this particular wavelength we are able to see the visible the light. So here the violet, it is having 400 nanometer, and here the wavelength are red having the highest wavelength, that is 700 nanometer. So here that is the wavelength, that and this is only the visible wavelength we can able to see. So now we are going to see that two more questions which is very important to know, that is, how does matter or atom emits light? So how does matter or atom emit light? We already discussed that the whatever the photon we get, the atom of the matter get absorb it and some get reflected, and this reflected part, reflected light we are able to see. So what happens in the atom, that and what, how does atom emit the light? So we have just recall the Bohr's model. The Bohr model is that there is a nucleus and the electron is revolving in us orbits, and they having some fixed orbit, some energy level. The orbits are also known as energy level. So what happens basically when any light or photon, when any light or we can say that the photon reach to the atoms, these atom absorb the photon, and we know that a photon is an energy particle. This photon is an energy particle. So what happens, this electron which is revolving in its own orbit, in own energy level, which we called it ground state, they get excited because this atom gets the energy, and due to this energy, these electron which is present in the ground state, means it's a normal state in its own orbit, they get excited and they jump to the next energy level. They jump to the next energy level. So you are able to see here the photon reaches here, and the photon is a form of energy particles, and due to this energy particle, this atom gains the energy, and the electron which is revolving around the nucleus, they get excited and they jump to the next energy level. But when it jump to the next energy level, they are unstable, and again they fall back to its ground state. Again it falls back. So here energy, when excited, they jump to the next energy level, and when, because they are unstable, after some time these electron fall back to the ground state, its own energy level. So during this they produce photon, and this photon having different, whatever the photon they produce, we know that they produce a different wavelength. They produce the photon of different wavelength or frequency, and in this way we are able to see the particular color of the object, the particular color emitted by the atom. So we have understood that how does matter emit light. When photon comes, reaches to the atom, the electrons get excited by taking the energy, and they jump to the next level, and when they get after some time, they fall back to their own energy level, ground state. During that, they, because they are the having the energy, so when they fall back to the ground state, they produce photon. This photon in the form of different wavelength. So we already discussed about the different wavelength, and according to that wavelength we are able to see the light, that what type of light they are producing. So in this way we can say that different element have different energy level, and due to that they have different color of light they emit, different wavelength of light they emit. I hope you understood that, you are able to understand this whole process, that how matter emit the light. Now next question, why matter have different color? So you are able to see that the leaves having different color, and we already know that the leaves having chloroplast, and due to this chlorophyll pigment, and this chlorophyll, this chlorophyll pigment means the leaf having the green color and the chloroplast that having chlorophyll pigment, they absorb red and blue light. So whatever the light they reflect green light. What they absorb, we are not able to see that light. We are able to see only that light which get reflected. So this leaf absorb all different wavelength of the light, but reflects green color light. That's why the leaves we are able to see are green in color. You are able to see here the white paper. Why this the paper is looking white? Because it reflects all the wavelength of light. And why this part is looking like black? Because it absorb all wavelength of light. They absorb all wavelength of light. So basically what the substance reflect, what the object reflect, we are able to see that part, that type of light, that color of light only. So this is all about the introduction of the human eye and colorful world.